had enough. Speaking down, but they know who coming up. And I'm still on my way. But the top don't look too far for me. Never caught off, not one day. And I'm still on my way. Still on my way. Yeah. I'm just greedy like Chubbs with a hustle like Poe. Trying to get it out the mud like what I'm supposed to do. It was in my blood, my family even knew. 22 I blew, I owe everything to truth. Some not or nothing, that's a cold situation. Know they probably hot, but they froze in the faces. I didn't even rush, I was chosen but patient. Feeling like Russ, I went gold out the basement. Get it by the running eagle chains by the dozen toe. That I love him, it's a whole celebration. Barely getting started, but still gotta embrace it. When it's from the bottom, it's a different foundation. Yeah, it's a different bag waiting on the other side. I just wanna live in salvation. We ain't had enough. Speaking down, but they know who coming up. And I'm still on my way. But the top don't look too far for me. Never caught off, not one day. And I'm still on my way, still on my way, and I'm still on my way,
still on my way.
But the top don't look too far for me.
No, the top don't look too far.
Never caught off, not one day.
Never caught off, not one day. Oh,
but I'm still on my way, yeah.
You want, what's the point at all? I'm living my best life. Got things on the hot library. Yeah, baby, if I don't keep it 100 with you, me and you will always have this issue. I'll make up your mind. You ain't gotta worry. You ain't gotta lie. You ain't gotta love me. Don't the vibe. Why you being petty? Oh, gotta stop being a I don't ever trip. That's not what I do. I'ma choose for you. Every single time you hit me up with a new excuse, I just fall back, I just fall back. Anytime I think that we getting close, you get out of pocket with me. Stop doing the most. I just hope your energy's the same. Soon as I go ghost, I just fall back, I just fall back. None of these other no. Me, cause I'm really ghost, yeah, baby. I gotta be your number one. Can't settle for no number two. So go ahead and keep playing dumb. Soon you're gonna have to face the truth. I'll make up your mind. You ain't gotta worry. You ain't gotta lie. You ain't gotta love me. Don't the vibe. Why you being petty? That's not what I do. All I know, if you can't make a choice, I'ma choose for you. Every single time you hit me up with a new excuse, I just fall back, I just fall back. Anytime I think that we getting close, you get out of pocket with me. Stop doing the most. I just hope your energy's the same. Soon as I go ghost, I just fall back, I just fall back. One time, with my get it girls, always looking so fine. So my put your hands to the ceiling. If they ain't with it, let them know. Fall back quick, I'ma let you go.
I don't ever trip, that's not what I do. All I know, if you can't make a choice, I'ma choose for you. Every single time you hit me up with a new excuse, I just fall back, I just fall back. Your
Yeah, 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 yeah. Creo con el Intomai, la mente rezando el Sky. Yeah. Tinto suelta la trompeta que siempre que lo hace un palo, Le PS, you know. Esta vida, mami, es un regalo. La isla se robó el show. Yo que solamente puse mi mano y Diosito me entregó el don. Te juro que se siente muy. Cuando eran tiempos de comienzo y tú estás pasando muy rápido, me da vertigo cada vez que lo pienso. Pero se me pasa cuando recuerdo todo el sacrificio y esfuerzo, yeah. O cuando ella me da un beso, cada vez que me pongo tenso. El día que me junté con Sergi, sabía de sobra que haríamos historia. Rebamos mil palos, reímos, lloramos, papi, y el resto es historia, yeah, yeah. Momentos que nunca se nos irán de la memoria. L.A., L.B., mami, A.K.A., los favoritos de tu novia. Nunca me olvido de los que estuvieron en los tiempos que estaban mal. De party con Rosito y Edu cuando pisa la capital. Es un día quiero que vos y Sao hablen en mi documental. Confiaron en mí cuando no era nadie, confiaron en mí cuando no había nada. Mami, ahora tenemos de todo, tenemos pa' coger. Ya no intenten hablar con Félix, él tampoco va a coger. 2021 sembrar, 2022 recoger, 2023 coronar, 2024 desaparecer, yeah. Mami, está tranquila, baby, está tranquilo. ¿Qué más quiero? El dinero no me pone contento, aunque ofrezca un 7-0. La Porsche cae en color, asientos de cuero. Pegado en la isla, pegado en España, pegado en el mundo entero. En el colegio, mi hermana frontea de ser mi hermana, yeah. Mi otra hermana también frontea de ser mi hermana, yeah. Mi piba frontea, se saca fotos, yeah. Y la mamá no frontea, pero podría solo por ser mi mamá. Me río porque habla de mí y eso que ni me ven. Y yo escribiendo y me vi en la cima sin querer. Y ahora solamente se ve la punta del iceberg. Papi, no hay uno más duro, si es que lo hay, dime quién. Yeah, 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 yeah. Que me doy con el Linton Mike. Yeah, LBS, you know. Pinto suelta la trompeta que siempre que lo hace un palo, LPS, you know. Esta vida, mami, es un regalo, la isla se robó el show. Yo que solamente puse mi mano y Diosito me entregó el don. Te juro que se siente muy que tus colegas sean tu inspiración. Solo éramos cuatro trabajando cuando eran tiempos de comienzo. Y tú estás pasando muy rápido, me da vertigo cada vez que lo pienso. Pero se me pasa cuando recuerdo todo el sacrificio y esfuerzo, yeah. O cuando ella me da un beso, cada vez que me pongo tenso.
Hi everyone, greetings from 2K Sports. Get ready for some NBA action. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Minnesota Timberwolves going up against the Washington Wizards. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Beard. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sidelines. Now we get a chance to check out some stats for Jordan Poole.
And right now, he's in one of those grooves where he has a tremendous feel for the game. His assist numbers these past five look a lot different than from the rest of the season. And by different, I mean better.
And now Washington starting group. Sliding into the wing spots, it's Poole and Avdija. Rashawn Holmes out there with Kyle Kuzma, and it's Jones in at the point. And for Minnesota, the two towering figures inside for him, Towns and Gobert. The wing set for him, Edwards and McDaniels. And it's Conley in at the one. And Greg, on paper, this looks like a real mismatch. These teams have very different expectations.
And in any matchup like this, the early stages are important. The team coming in as a big underdog has to keep it close, otherwise things can go south in a hurry.
To the middle, here's Holmes, and Holmes throws it down.
And getting the positioning he wants and finishing. Love to watch Holmes work on the inside.
Edwards against Poole.
Oh! Wow. Okay. What a huge flush by Edwards, showing off right now.
Conley against Jones. There's the pass to Poole. Back to Jones. Edwards against Poole. Kuzma passes to Avdija. Shot clock at five. Kuzma can't get it to go. Minnesota with the ball. Edwards with it. Holmes covering. with the floater. Good work defensively by Holmes. So for Washington, their last game, a loss to the Timberwolves in Minnesota.
Yeah, let's give a shout out to their defense in that one. The intensity, the shot blocking, just a dominant performance.
Yeah, last game was pretty impressive stuff on that end of the floor, just getting up near shooters and blocking as many shots as they did.
And unbothered by the contact inside. Edwards plays the game with so much physicality.
Jones kicks to Poole. Pass to Holmes to the left wing. Kuzma, left side. Kicks it out to Jones. And again, Washington with the triple.
What a feed from Kuzma. I like when he finds the open man, and so do they.
Right side, Edwards. And he drops. Oh! Oh!
Nice.
That's a rugged play.
Gracious. What is it you say, Kev? Up high and down hard.
Oh, exactly, GA. You've got to say it emphatically. He was soaring up high, down hard.
That's what the fans, they want to see it. Shooting 4 of 5 to start the game, that's got to be a feel good.
After 2 consecutive first-round exits, Greg, the Timberwolves are looking to take that next step.
And with Anthony Edwards at the helm, I think they will soon. But you have to remember, he is only 22 years old, and when your star is that young, you typically have to endure some growing pains before breaking through.
Here's Towns, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
First personal foul.
It's going to go on Tyus Jones.
And you got to like Towns being assertive there. When he plays like this, it really makes the defenders uncomfortable.
First trip to the line for him here.
And with his percentage at 87, he's done just about everything they could have asked when it comes to free throw shooting.
And that drops, so they now lead by 1. Greg, it seems like the Wizards have been trying to find their edge against tough teams.
Yeah, and the first question is, which end does it happen on, offense or defense? Because you can win tough games by being great at either.
He's off on the second.
And one of the game's elite shooters, and Towns' sweet stroke definitely extends to the free throw line.
Kuzma passes to Holmes. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Here's Edwards. Here he goes.
Oh, yeah! How about the athleticism from Edwards rocketing off the drive there for the slam?
Nice job capturing the moments on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Wizards trail by 3. Pass to Holmes. Kicks to Jones. Passes to Abdia. Here's Holmes. Jones for 3. And again, Washington, no good. Towns against Poole. And that one's good, Towns.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And it's Jones with the ball for the Wizards. It's a 5-point game. Last time they came together was in Minnesota, where they felled the Wolves.
Yeah, and they got beat last time these two teams met, and really, free throws were the story. And he's really been working to get those looks, and it's starting to pay off here early on.
Here is Conley. Tyus Jones picking up that last basket. And that one's good. Towns.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
And so it's Washington with it. Inside, here's Kuzma. And Kuzma slams it in.
Look at the ups on Kyle Kuzma.
Minnesota leading by 3. Down low. He's against Kuzma. Can't get it to fall.
A lot of defenders choose to just back up off of him when he's in that tight, try to avoid the and one, and this time they're not backing off.
Now, here's Holmes. He averages about 5 points a game. The shot that time, not on target. Gobert with the defensive effort. The Timberwolves have gone 7-9 from the field. A really nice start offensively for them. Conley gets the bucket.
Oh, what a feed right there. Towns' vision is really off the charts.
Wizards trail by 5. And here's Avdija. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Minnesota.
Yeah, but all around offensively, the performance was great. He knew when he had it going, but he also knew he could get other guys going. So his passing right up there on the level with his scoring in that one.
Good on the bucket. Conley's got 6.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
Now, here's Avdija. He's covered closely. And the pass to Holmes. Now, here's Poole. Poole, a screen on Conley. Jones, no one around him. Offline with his 3. Timberwolves leading by 4. Here's Towns. Down it goes, his 3rd basket. He's now 3 for 4.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Timeout call here. The first for Washington. And late in the regular season, Greg, in your decade plus in the NBA, you were looking forward to the playoffs more often than not.
And as a player, you have to avoid that temptation to look ahead. But when you do, much nicer to look forward to the playoffs than vacation.
Two games left before the start of the playoffs. Let's take a look at the possible field. Taking a look at Minnesota. They've got their eye on the number 1 seed as the season moves into the final stretch. Currently first place in the standings. And guys showing no signs of letting up.
And I think for Minnesota, with the regular season they've enjoyed, it has to be wondered at this point if they're the team to beat this postseason.
Jones looking for an opening. Ball's knocked loose. The 3. Carl Anthony Towns with the rebound. Now the Timberwolves with it. They're on a 17-7 run. And he banks in the layup. Towns has got 9.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Wizards trail by 8. Here's Kuzma. And Kuzma slams it in.
And Poole's vision developing right in front of us.
Here is Conley. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Washington. Here's Towns. And again, it's Minnesota converting.
D has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
Kuzma outside. Here's Avdija. Poole with no one around. Hands it from downtown. Poole's got a pair of 3s now in the first quarter for the Wizards. And Edwards the the stop.
Man, he's a pure point guard with terrific vision. Conley finds open teammates at times before they realize they're open.
Now, here's Poole. He has six. Knocks down the three ball.
Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
And Towns the bucket and the assist from Conley. 13 points in the game.
Pretty easy right now. Clear out, give him some space, let him get to work.
Out to the wing. A wide open look here for Kuzma. That three off the mark.
I'm shocked that it didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
And Greg, it just seems like every night Kyle Kuzma is going to put up double digits.
And he has the potential to be a double-double threat. Just needs to get more aggressive on the glass.
Now here's Jones. After the miss from Karl Anthony Towns. Down low. And Kuzma slams it in.
So far, both teams scorching the Nets. You gotta love it.
Yeah, made for TV game here. Pace is great. Scoring is coming in bunches. And both of the teams feeling confident right now.
Conley's shot is off.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Avdija kicks to Kuzma. Poole the pass to Holmes. Lost contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And there's the strength coming through of Rashawn Holmes, the and one.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Timberwolves.
Tons of points off penetration so far, guys. They're driving at will on the defense, just taking whatever they want.
Let's make sure that that selfish nerve doesn't get tapped, because right now there's great ball movement. They're setting each other up. Let's see if that maintains.
Holmes, no good on the free throw.
Rashawn Holmes, look at those throwback five types. You know, the big burly guys that play physical, that like to rebound, bang around on the inside, and score in there as well.
Morris with the bucket. Wizards trail by four. Here's Champagne. Over to the wing. Holmes kicks to Avdija. The Wizards with another miss.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
And it's Towns penetrating.
And how about the game from Towns? The combination of that height and shooting, probably unmatched in the NBA.
Washington calls timeout.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it. Make the adjustment.
Turned out for him. He's averaging 8 points, 5 assists, and 4 rebounds. And he's a nice scoring threat in their second unit, a guy who provides instant offense.
and he has really settled into this role. For some guys, maybe him, they'd rather come off the bench and do their damage.
Avdija, no scoring in this one. Pass to Shamet. Here's Champagny. Just five to shoot. The Wizards need to get a shot off here. Here's Shamet. The Wizards with another miss.
And that one gives them a plus five rebound advantage.
Towns down low, guarded by Holmes. Towns with the bucket. And it's an 8-point Timberwolves lead.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
And Holmes throws it down.
The defense so concerned with Shamet and his shot-making ability, he makes the play that time.
Anderson right side. Over Kispert. And again, it's Minnesota converting.
In the mid-range. Rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
The shot's good from Kispert.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And Morris has got the ball here for the Timberwolves. 6-point lead. Here's Alexander Walker. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Great vision from Morris, makes the next pass. That's what you want.
Here's Shamet. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. He dishes it to Avdija. Up top, Holmes. Pass to Shamet. To Holmes. Again, the Wizards score.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Minnesota leading by 6. Here's Reed. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And his presence as a scorer, it just has a calming effect for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need him.
Now, here's Avdija. Still scoreless. Kispert dishes to Avdija. He kicks it to Kispert. Wizards passing it around. 4 on the clock. Holmes has a screen. Shamet the pass to Holmes. Towns with the defensive effort.
Team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy. And theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
And that one drops for him.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Now, here's Shamet, covered by Morris. We've got 13 seconds left to play in the first quarter. The 17-footer. The shot's good. And it's a 12-point Timberwolves lead.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything.
It's been all about Karl Anthony Towns for the Timberwolves. What an amazing quarter. There was absolutely no stopping him. Back to the action in just a minute. And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Timberwolves?
Yeah, in that first period, they looked to push in transition at every opportunity.
It felt like they knew that there were openings in transition and just wanted to keep trying to feed that, get out quick.
Minnesota leading by 9.
Anderson is out there with Nas Reed. Then there's Anthony Edwards. Then it's Morris. Then it's Alexander Walker in at the small forward position. So that's the lineup for Minnesota. Shamet the pass to Bagley. And that's a foul called on Nas Reed. That's his first foul.
First team foul.
With a screen on Morris. Here's Shamet, and it's Kispert in the corner. And the Wizards hit again from deep.
Yeah, that's two straight three-pointers they've allowed.
And so it's Minnesota with it. Following this game, they hit the road to challenge the Nuggets at Ball Arena in Denver. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip.
Well, Slow-Mo has some remarkable handles, a point forward that's got some nifty dribble moves.
Greg, taking a look at Monte Morris for a second. You got to be inspired by his terrific story.
I mean, from late second round pick to a seasoned NBA player, Morris never gave up on himself and continues to impress with each passing season.
Here's Edwards, and there's another one for the Timberwolves.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Passes it to Champagne. A three-pointer off the mark.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Here's Alexander Walker. Good, nice job down low. Alexander Walker's got the lead up to 14 now for the Timberwolves. Washington has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. To the paint. A shot's good from Kispert. Kispert's got 7 points.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Right now, I'd send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Now, Jordan Poole has more freedom to create than ever before. He said there's a small group of people who get that chance. You have to make the most of your opportunity and put yourself in position to be successful. I never want any moment to be too big. Kevin, the ball is in his court now.
Yep, just the way he wants it. All right, D.A., thanks so much. Jordan McLaughlin's checked in for Monte Morris. Poole's checked in for Washington. Tyus Jones comes in for Landry Shamet. Timberwolves leading by 14. Here's Edwards. And finished off by Edwards.
At this point, I don't know what you can do to slow this team down.
Well, nothing that they're doing seems to be making an impact. And there are some nights where you just run out of options, whether it's by personnel or by tactic.
And Poole gets it to go.
Guys, he's been a one-man air raid coming at them time and time again.
Kind of like he's in his living room right now. He's found a comfort zone. Once he gets that, the defense knows they're in trouble.
You know, you'd love to see him pull that off, but instead he goes from highlight reel to the bloopers.
Edwards against Jones. Banked in off the glass. Jones has got his third basket of the night.
Now all the way to the bucket, no resistance, just swipe the candy from him.
Timberwolves have gotten all but one of their 7 shots in the second quarter to drop. Pretty impressive. And the shot goes in. And the Timberwolves lead by 13.
Oh, great production on the interior right now. 8 straight from inside.
Jones drives in, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Jones has got 4 points now in the quarter.
And, you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
Wizards trail by 11. The pass to Bagley. Here's Kuzma. A three-pointer, no good.
Well, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. He must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
Near the three-point line, it's Edwards. It's rebounded by Poole.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Kuzma sets a screen. Jones, the pass to Kispert. Back to Jones. There's the three. Rebound, Minnesota. At one point, they led by 16. Edwards with it. Picked up by Kuzma. Edwards, that's good.
And don't let Edwards' position fool you. Anthony is built like a linebacker. That upper body strength helps him down low.
Pass to Kispert. And there it is for him. Kispert's got 9 points. Timberwolves leading by 11. Here's Edwards, and finished off by Edwards.
It's simple, guys. Keep getting Edwards the ball and just let Ant cook.
Jones with it. He's got 9. Kuzma outside, and it's Kispert in the corner. Off target with his 3. And it's Anderson with the ball for Minnesota. Here's Alexander Walker from down in the low post. It goes. Alexander Walker's got 6 points in the quarter. Wizards trail by 15. Over in the corner, Poole. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Jones has got 6 assists in the game. And you think of height as an advantage in basketball, but, Greg, the versatility at such a premium. Can you be too tall in today's NBA?
It's a valid question. The two biggest concerns for seven-footers are mobility and durability. To move the way they need to puts a lot of strain on those lower extremities.
Comes in for Anderson. McDaniels, he's checked in for Alexander Walker. And it's Mike Conley in for Jordan McLaughlin. And a change for the Wizards. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Bagley. Minnesota leading by 12. Towns, and the dunk by Towns.
Plenty of power on that slam. Towns was not messing around.
Here's Poole. A 24-point outing in their last game against Minnesota. And Holmes now, top of the key. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. The Wizards shooting their 2nd and 3rd shots at the line right here.
Holmes taking 2 shots.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws good from Holmes. Now, many people say officiating favors the offense. Brent, do you agree with that?
Absolutely. That's what this game is about. It's about scoring. And so there aren't many rule changes that are going to stop guys from being as potent as they've been offensively, especially over the last couple years.
Up top, Holmes. He takes it in, and Holmes throws it down.
Lots of muscle coming at you when Holmes is on the drive, and he makes that pretty intimidating.
Here's McDaniels. 2 points. That one goes. McDaniels got his first 2 points of the night.
They own the interior right now. 10 straight points coming from inside.
Holmes with a screen on come. Here's Kispert. And the rejection by Towns.
A firm denial by Towns, knocking it away with that tremendous length.
Timberwolves leading by 12. Pass to McDaniels. Yep, it counts. McDaniels got 4 points now in the quarter.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
To the wing on the left. Kispert, wide open, he fires. Off target from three-point range. Passes it to McDaniels. Over Kispert. And the Timberwolves jack on two more.
Nice pass here to set that basket up.
So for the Wizards, their last game, a loss to the Minnesota Timberwolves.
Got to give him an A for effort. Just fell a little bit short in that.
Well, it would have been really nice to get that win on the road. But no team ever happy with a loss. Put up a good fight. They had nothing to hang their heads on after that one.
And the defense has to bring more fire than we're seeing. Gobert just fighting through all of it.
To the inside. Holmes. And Holmes throws it down.
And in terms of size, not your typical center, but man, he plays as big as any of them thanks to that terrific leaping ability.
Here's Towns, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Kyle Kuzma picks one up.
A nice intensity from Towns in the paint. Doesn't back off and takes that shot while being fouled.
The Timberwolves shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. He's off on the first. Minnesota making a switch here. Alexander Walker's checked in. And a switcher also for Washington. Javier's checked in for Kyle Kuzma. And he's good on the second. Now, Avdija, scoreless thus far. And there's the pass to Kispert. Connects from three-point range.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Enzo Conley will bring the ball up for the Timberwolves. They led by as many as 18 points. Count that bucket. Towns has got 26 points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Pass to Avdija. Back to Jones. Over in the corner, Avdija. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Jones has got his 7th assist here tonight.
He's going to punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
And it's Towns missing.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Holmes with a screen on cover. Jones kicks to Holmes. Now, here's Kispert. McDaniels defending. just 5 on the clock. Jones, no luck.
Shot didn't fall, but that play worked well to get a good look at the basket.
Yeah, an efficient offensive possession. They found the look that they wanted, just didn't go in. And this story in the second quarter, much different than the one in the first. We're finally seeing some aggression.
Jones against Conley. Outside, Jones. Kispert, the pass to Holmes. The three from Poole. And the Wizards hit again from deep.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Outside, Towns. Jacks up a three. Rebound by the Wizards. Holmes got his 6th rebound on the night. Poole kicks to Jones. Back to Poole. Takes a three. Minnesota with the rebound. Gobert's got 4 rebounds in this game. Towns for 3. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Conley's got assist number 8 here in this one already. Conley against Jones. Tipped away. Stolen by Michael Conley. Plays it in off the breakaway. Conley's got 8 points.
And a terrific two-way player. Conley capable of dominating possessions all by himself.
Now, here's Poole. Tight defense on him. And another miss by Washington.
And they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now is massive. And it just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Wizards trailed by 19. Outside, Jones. Holmes setting the big for Jones. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That is his first foul of the game. Minnesota calls timeout.
Well, whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
Change for the Wizards. Kuzma's checked in. Seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Here's Holmes, and Holmes throws it down.
Yeah, this is some found change in the couch. They're not relying on Holmes to have these kind of offensive nights.
Poole against Moore. And he hammers that one down right in the face of Rashawn Holmes.
Oh, let's
let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. Now, here's Kuzma. Shoots over Towns. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for it. And so a pretty lopsided game through the first half. Timberwolves lead by 19. A chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Carl. Impressive start for you. What's the mentality going into a game like this?
Just being aggressive. Really played well at all the first half myself. All of us are missing a lot of easy bunnies. We're missing layups for us as pros. So second half, if we make those layups, we should be fine.
We'll see if you stick to the script. Thanks very much, man. Back to you.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three.
Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet and the Big Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. How about we start out with the Western Conference and how those teams are stacking up? And fellas, it's interesting. Talk of divisional standings has almost completely been phased out.
Yeah, I miss those battles. I remember the Spurs against the Jazz with David Robinson, Karl Malone.
That's because you didn't have to guard either of them.
Yeah, but you're right.
Yes, Shaq, you are right. Now, for a moment to look at our game, everything, and I mean everything, is falling into place for the Minnesota Timberwolves.
Well, you look at their game plan tonight, it's obvious. Get the ball inside and go to work. And so far, it's been working very well for them.
Listen, the way they're playing now, if they stay disciplined, this game could be over in the third quarter.
And that's all for us. Now it's time to send it back to Kevin Harlan for the beginning of the third quarter.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Carl Anthony Towns has been sensational.
Well, it didn't take him long to get that double-double. Already has it halfway through the game.
Yeah, guys like him love to stuff the stat sheet. He's doing it here.
Timberwolves leading by 19 points. So on the floor for Washington. In the backcourt, it's Jones and Poole. In at the forward positions, Avdija and Kuzma. And it's Holmes in at the five, roaming the paint. and the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. The Timberwolves have gone Twin Towers with Karl Anthony Towns and Rudy Gobert. Gobert says, I love playing with another dominant big because I've always thought that I could pass. I know that I can make guys around me better. Kat says, we complement each other. He's a generational talent on defense, and I think I'm a generational talent on offense. And Kevin, I'm a generational talent on sideline.
You are indeed, and that's why you are in Springfield. No argument here, David. Thank you. Here's Edwards, and Edwards with the stuff.
Flying high, Anthony Edwards, ladies and gents, clear for takeoff.
Second half just getting started, about a minute played. Wizards trailed by 21. And here's Avdija. Here's Jones. Buries the 20-footer. Jones has got 11.
Assist from Holmes.
For Minnesota, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Here's Edwards into the lane and finished off by Edwards.
And once Edwards gets a step on you, it's likely going to be a bucket or a foul or both.
Nice angle on that replay with the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for the Wizards. And Holmes now, top of the key. Over in the corner, Poole. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Timberwolves leading by 21. There's McDaniels. Yes, once again, it remains perfect. 6 attempts and 6 hits.
Moving it around. 8 of the last 10 coming off assists.
Holmes with a screen on cup. Jones kicks to Holmes. Second shot opportunity, and the layup is good. Holmes got 20 points.
Yeah, coaches from the sideline screaming, get a body on Rashawn Holmes, why don't you?
Holmes with the steal. Jones with it. Picked up by Edwards. Jones against Edwards. Jones sets the pick for Kuzma. Cranes the three-pointer. 14 points for him.
And this is where Kuzma wants to just keep improving, find some consistency. He knows guys like him have to keep hitting threes to stay on the floor.
And they pick up 2. And the Timberwolves lead by 20.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
And now we're 3 minutes into the third.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yes. That's for sure. For Washington, they've gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Holmes finds Poole. From past the arc. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Jones has got assist number 9 now. Wow, what an effort here tonight. Minnesota leading by 19 points. Here's Conley. That one rolling around and rims out. Washington's gone 2 of 3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. Poole against Edwards. Holmes with a screen on Edwards. Poole, no good.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
Here's Towns. And he slams it down right on top of Kenny Avdija.
Oh, Karl Anthony Towns with a little extra emphasis on that one.
Pass to Holmes. And the wide-open shot from Avdija. No good on the triple. For Minnesota, they've gone 7-9 from the field to start this second half. Some tremendous shooting from them. And finished off by McDaniel.
Okay, 2 hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question. That one goes. Count it. Avdija's got 5 now.
Not getting old here. Seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
McDaniels kicks to Edwards. And finished off by Edwards.
And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Yeah, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that one. Poole, a screen on Cotton. Jones, the pass to Poole. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
And it's scary how much scoring potential a player like Jordan Poole has.
Here's McDaniels. And finished up by McDaniel.
I love the unselfishness. And you know coaches do as well.
Well, not just coach, but you can see it in the teammates, the way that they look at him, they appreciate it when he shares the ball like that.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
Timberwolves leading by 20. Over to the left wing. Here's Towns, and Towns throws it down.
That's the guy they're going to keep going to, as they should. The lead's only going up if they keep beating him.
Down low. And chance shot. Holmes, good. Holmes got 22.
And these high percentage shots is what Rashawn Holmes gets paid for. He could be a real force in the paint.
Outside, Towns. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Second personal foul.
So I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves.
I like how simple they are just keeping things on offense. I mean, the mid-range area has been made available, and boy, are they taking advantage.
All game long, they've just done a great job of keeping the pressure on the defense and penetrating with the pass. They've gotten everything inside, and they've converted there.
The free throw drops for Towns. Kyle Anderson, he's checked in for McDaniels. And Towns drops them both. Here's Jones. He's got 11. And there's the 3 second call. This one on the defense. And we have to take another glance at that powerful rejection.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And they have really leaned on his free throw shooting at times this season. He's been there for them, too, with 88% from the line.
And so he hits the technical free throw.
And Jordan Poole has stepped onto the NBA stage and not ever backed down from the challenge. He plays with tremendous confidence.
Wizards making a switch here. Kispert's checked in. Gobert brings the double team to the middle. Here's Poole. It falls for basket number 9 from the field. He's taken 14 shots to get there.
Those are two tough points from Poole. Great to see him mixing it up down low.
Here's Edwards. And finished off by Edwards.
Oh, he is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. Wizards trail by 21. Over in the corner, Poole. Three-pointer. And again, Washington with the triple.
I mean, he is bringing his game, guys. Another jumper from distance.
And so it's Conley bringing up the ball for Minnesota. Here's Edwards.
Oh. Passes like this demonstrate Conley's unselfishness as well as his desire to get his guys going on offense.
Jones kicks to Holmes. Back to Jones. Here's Kispert. And a miss there on the triple. Minnesota leading by 20. Anderson inside. That's in there. Conley with the assist. 6 points for Kyle Anderson.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling now.
Holmes setting the pick for Poole. Trying to find Holmes. Gets it to him. Yep, that one goes. Holmes got 8 here in the quarter. Minnesota calls timeout.
Timberwolves timeout call.
Start of the playoffs. Let's take a look at the possible field. Taking a look at Washington, it hasn't been a great season for them. We may see some changes in the offseason. Timberwolves leading by 20. Conley surveying the D, and it's good for 2. Conley's got 10.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Jones, the pass to Holmes. Jones against Conley. Jones kicks to Poole. In the corner, Holmes with it. Wide open. It's rebounded by Towns. Towns has got 14 rebounds tonight. Going after. Conley's shot is off. Washington's gone to the three-point shot 8 times already in the second half and hit 4 of them. Passes it to Poole. From the arc. Rebound Minnesota. Anderson outside. Over Kispert. And it's Anderson that time on the assist by Towns. Towns has got assist number 8 here in this one already. A difficult situation for Washington. Poole with it. He has 29. Now Jones. It's rebounded by Towns. And here are the Timberwolves. They lead by 24. Their biggest margin over Jones. The quick look, no good that time. The Wizards shooting well, 52% in the third. They came to play offensively in the second half. Kispert setting the pick for Jones. The pass to Kispert. Here's Holmes. Right through the D for the Lions. Holmes got 10 points here in the second half.
And Holmes can be a tough cover, especially in that two-man game.
For 3, Edwards. The offensive rebound. It's tipped. It's stolen by Jones. Inside. Stolen by Anderson. And now the Timberwolves on the break. Conley gets the bucket. Conley's got 4 points this quarter.
Gotta admire how clever Conley is. Gifted at catching the defense off guard with that soft float.
Conley against Jones. kicks it to Kispert. Jones sets the pick for Kispert. Back to Jones. Oh, and he pucks it off the glass. Wow. Count the basket. Jones has got 13.
And so far, going for more of an inside presence here in the second half, getting away from the three-point shot.
And the Timberwolves call time here.
Attention fans, now on the court is your hype squad. Get loud and let them hear it.
Gobert. Alexander Walker comes in for Edwards. And Monte Morris subbed in for Mike Conley. Minnesota leading by 22. Pass to Reed. Shoots over Kuzma. And they'll get another chance. Here's Towns. That one drops for him. Towns has got 39.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
Kuzma outside. Misses the three. And so it's Morris with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota.
And recently, I mean, we've seen Kyle Kuzma turn things around, especially offensively.
Yeah, Greg, highs and lows in the early part of Kyle Kuzma's career, but a nice settled ground for him. Offensively, he's carried more responsibility and shown that he's capable of doing it.
Bagley the pass to Champagne. Here's Kispert, and he's good on the three ball. Kispert's got 15 points.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Shamet the pass to Kuzma. And Kuzma slams it in.
Ooh, he put a little extra on that one.
He does. He doesn't usually finish soft either. Obviously, he can when necessary, but not that time. The shot's good from Alexander Walker.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another.
Kuzma outside. He kicks it to Kispert. From outside, off the mark.
I'm not sure how he finds himself in so much space there. He's kicking himself for whiffing a bit on that one.
Here's Towns, and it's good from the elbow. Towns has got 41.
He is at his best when it matters most. This game is theirs as long as he can keep this up.
They get a hand on it. Stolen by Reed. He got it up. And so it's Minnesota holding a very comfortable 25-point lead as the quarter comes to a close. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And he's always been the favorite to bag this honor. These kind of feeds are his bread and butter.
Doesn't happen with every point guard in the league as far as setting your teammates up. Lots more scorers now, but right there creating the scoring opportunity for his teammate.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. We've got Naz Reid. Morris is out there with Edwards. Then there's Warren, and it's Alexander Walker in at the three spot. So that's the lineup for Minnesota.
Oh, Bagley punishing the defense that time.
Shot's good by Alexander Walker.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Pass to Bagley. Here's Champagne. Edwards defending. Puts it up from 12. A rebound by the Timberwolves.
How about that hard-nosed D in the paint right there? Nice job.
Yeah, he cut off every angle and then got his body on him. That's a Warriors effort.
And it's really good to see Edwards knock down the mid-range jumper. He continues to work on becoming more consistent from that area.
Up top, Bagley. Shoots over Reed. Bagley with the bucket. Bagley's got 4 points now in the quarter. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. And the wide-open shot from Warren. The shot's good on the assist by Morris. Morris has got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. For Washington, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. Kuzma outside. Off target from outside.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Near the three-point line, it's Morris. And the shot is long. Washington shooting 55% from the floor. They're feeling very confident offensively. That bucket in no time at all.
Well, when he's not spotting up, part of his offensive arsenal is Shamit's pull-up game.
Near the three-point line, it's Morris. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. For Washington, they've gone 3 of 5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Here's Shamit. No good on the three. The Timberwolves have gone an outstanding 4 of 5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Warren. Rebound by the Wizards. Kuzma's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Kispert, the pass to Champagne. Three-pointer Bagley. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Edwards got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Near the three-point line, it's Morris. Kuzma pulls it in.
He loved to make them pay for giving up that wide-open jumper, just unable to do so.
And finish off by Bagley.
That's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Here's Alexander Walker. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
And guys, you've heard of overpassing. Well, that shot was an example of underpassing.
Maybe they can find a way to establish some rhythm in the next few possessions with the extra pass. Now, the D has done a very poor job at contesting him from outside, guys. He's tearing into them right now, and they cannot stop him.
Pulls from the top of the key, and once again off the mark by Minnesota. Wizards trailed by 21. Here's Champagne. It's up a 3. Kuzma can't get it to go. Timberwolves shooting 44% in the fourth. The offense with some ups and downs. Here's Alexander Walker. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
Pretty lax defense there. He's going to see fewer and fewer chances if he can't bury those kind of jumpers.
Kispert kicks to Shamit. To the paint. Here's Kuzma. It's blocked.
Well, TJ, improving his awareness on defense is something that coaches are looking for. Nice block there.
Timberwolves leading by 19. In the corner, it's Morris. Shoots over Shamit. Morris, no good.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Kuzma passes to Shamit. takes it off the glass. Shamet's got 5 points in the quarter.
And Kuzma showing more and more that he's becoming a playmaker on the offensive end of the floor.
Here's Alexander Walker. That one goes in. And the Timberwolves lead by 19.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
Here's the screen. And there's the defensive 3 second call.
Washington ball. Key for Washington. Share it. At the line for Washington.
Shows the focus there, nails the technical.
Landry Shamet, one of those guys continuing to hone his skills, trying to become more of an impactful player in the two-way format, both on defense and with that shooting ability.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Minot's checked in, and it's Kyle Anderson in for Nickeil Alexander-Walker. Now, here's Shamet. And here is Holmes. And Holmes throws it down.
He just powered that one down.
One of the game's top dunkers. Minnesota leading by 16. Edwards inside. He's covered by Shamet. And there's Edwards on the assist by Anderson. Anderson's got 3 assists tonight. And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for the Wizards. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Holmes wide open. He fires. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Edwards inside. He's covered by Shamet. And Edwards with the stop.
Aggressive drive by Edwards going into attack mode on that one.
Wizards trail by 20. Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. And with some of the new rooting interest for fans, some concern about potential hostility for the players when great things don't go their way.
I mean, there's a lot riding on the outcome of games and stat lines. And that's something the league has to take seriously, making sure the players are protected because the emotions can run rampant.
On defense, the Timberwolves. Stolen by Michael Conley. And now the Timberwolves on the break. on up the court. And Edwards with the stop.
Anderson has great vision as a point forward. Exceptional court awareness.
Avdija with it. To the middle. Edwards with the block. Well, we've had this new playoff format since 2021, adding that play-in tournament. How do you like it?
Well, I love it. You're just giving more high-level teams a chance at a swing for a championship. I mean, look what happened last year and how exciting that was for the NBA and the play-in tournament. Using those hops to attack the rim, Poole takes flight.
Timberwolves leading by 22. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
Just no resistance inside at all. They are feasting. This is a straight buffet.
It is. It's a big one. And load the plate.
Anthony Edwards. One shot.
One shot.
Washington's gone a disappointing 2-6 on three-point attempts here in the fourth. Poole on the wing. Edwards defending. Here's Kuzma. No good from outside.
He's getting good looks on the floor, but he simply cannot bury anything right now. He's got to stay confident, though, because everyone knows he can hit those shots.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
I mean, this team is just dangerous. Right now, every shot that they're putting up feels like it's going in.
Here's Jones. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That one is on time. Hey, Brent, in general, as we widen the lens here, what do you think current NBA teams could do better?
Well, it's going to be interesting, Kevin, to see how, with the defensive three-second rule sort of disappearing, how many more coaches are able to implement combinations of zone defenses. They're going to take away what it is that a team likes to do in the half court of their execution. Along with that, certainly, clock management, timeouts, maybe more usage of their actual roster going a little bit deeper during the regular season to explore those kind of tactics. And don't forget about all those experiments. They could happen in the G League as well.
Yeah, and his performance has been a jaw dropper. It must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
And with the playoffs on the horizon, he'll be looking to stay in peak form as long as he can. And the first one drops. And so Jones nails both of them.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
And so Edwards will bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. And another one falls. Amazing.
My goodness. 50 for the game.
Yep, he is putting on a show. Jones against Conley. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Conley. A floater, and he lays it up and in. Conley's got 4 points in the quarter.
No hesitation at all in transition, and they have a huge margin in that department.
Jones, the pass to Avdija. Jones with the screen on Towns. Kuzma kicks to Avdija. Jones, that's for two. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Edwards, and there's the drive, and the layup's good off the glass. Edwards got 52 points.
Offensively, it's been a perfect quarter for him. He hasn't missed a single shot.
The three from Poole bangs home the trifecta.
What an exhibition he's putting on today. This is about as hot as you can get.
Stolen by Avdija. Inside, and Holmes throws it down.
And another area where Poole continues to work has just become a much more effective passer.
It's Edwards on the wing. Here's Towns. The 17-footer goes down. Towns has got 43 points.
Yeah, he's got to knock that down if you give it to him. Uncompetitive there defensively.
The defense also looking defeated. The lack of hustle is driving the coaching staff a little bit batty right now.
Pass to Poole. Three-pointer. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Avdija with the rebound. Wizards shooting it well here in the fourth quarter, 50%. Back to Jones. Gobert brings the double team. Kuzma outside. And the three off target.
Well, after an impressive first half, he's just not been able to get the room or get anything going here in the second.
Gobert. And again, another assist.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. Jones against Conley. The pass to Poole. Here's the three. Rebound, Minnesota. Here's Gobert. It's rebounded by Poole. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That's foul number 2 for him. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Nas Reed, he's checked in for Gobert. Alexander Walker comes in for Towns. And Jordan McLaughlin subbed in for Mike Conley. The Wizards shooting an efficient 53% from the field. And Jones has it in the corner. Krills it from outside. Jones has got 9 points here in the second half.
So many of the plays they're running designed to create opportunities from deep.
And I don't know how they keep doing this, but every time down, the resulting possession ends up at the 3-point line in a fairly efficient shot attempt at that.
And so it looks like Washington will retain possession here. The Timberwolves making a switch here. Minot's checked in.
Josh Minot.
1:46 left in the fourth quarter of this one. To the right side. Here's Holmes. And it's off from 3-point range. Pass to Minot. High post try. And he makes that one.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for Minnesota.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought. An all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And the wins continue to come in fairly easy for these guys in what's been a very strong year, to say the least. Tonight will push them up to 56 wins.
And they've really had a dominant run of games against this opponent this year. They played them three times and won every one.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Karl Anthony Towns.
I liked his aggressiveness here tonight, especially on the glass. He was not messing around.
Avdija kicks to Holmes. Let's it go from deep. The shot's good from Kuzma.
And that's a learned skill from Kuzma. Not all forwards can get rid of it like that.
And the Timberwolves call time here. Minot on the inbound, takes it inside.
This arena was rocking throughout the night. You can really feel the energy.
And a huge motivation, always great for a young team, but veteran players also appreciate when fans come with that kind of energy and get into the spirit of the game. That's just a lapse right there. No matter what, somebody has to be there and get a hand up in the shooter's face.
Here's McLaughlin. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for the Washington Wizards. Pass to Holmes. They swipe it. Fires from 18. No good off the back of the rim. Now Jones. And so it's the Timberwolves taking care of business here. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go. And once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Mike. The game is flowing for you. What is it like to be on a win streak like this?
Well, the game just back to being easy again, you know, just making the right plays, playing off of the teammates, and guys are just really being unselfish, and it's easy for me to play in that style, and it's fun to be around.
You sure look like you're having fun, man. Thanks very much. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Karl Anthony Towns.